Alright guys, how is it? It's about 4 a.m. right now, so I'm not gonna talk that loud. Can't sleep right now. And since people like what's his name? Let me search it. You know, again, I'm unprepared. I like making videos out of the blue. I was gonna reply to Chrono X Asura's comment, but I figured, why not make another video? Because, you know, I hate Nintendo, like some of the other commenters say. Like, let me check out that. Let me check out these comments, y'all. Let's see. Let me address these. Alright. Dweem 2009. Abel. Pretendo faggot. You know, that would be true if I didn't bother, you know, to buy most recent games, you know, because surely, I could pretend to be a Nintendo fan when, you know, I get Club Nintendo stuff. You know, I have all these games. There's more games over here, though these are most of my 3DS games, if I'm not mistaken. You know, I could pretend, you know, when I bought games like Final Fantasy, Crystal Bearers, you know. You won't hear that many people who bought Final Fantasy, Crystal Bearers, or you won't hear people who bought Excitebots. You know, hell, I got games like the Blob, the fucking Blob, man. Like, I'm not a fake fan. You know, why would I want a Wii U if I played Monster Hunter 3 already? I mean, like, I understand that Monster Hunter is fun, but if I'm not mistaken, these take place in majority of the same places. I didn't really read up on Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate or whatever the fuck they want to call it this time. You know, I'm not a fake fan. If I have sin and punishment, like, I don't care what anybody says. Like, let me find it. Where's my 3DS? Can't find it right now, can I? Like, if people could, like, lie to themselves all they want, but I'm not gonna do that. Like, I'm a Nintendo fan. Like, I don't care what anybody says. I am a Nintendo. I've been there. I've played so many games by Nintendo. And, matter of fact, some of my most favorite games of all time is Nintendo. Like I said, Super Mario Galaxy 2. The only game I can think that comes close to those two games are Red Dead Redemption. Maybe Okami is probably in my top 10 because I really enjoyed that. Had a great story, but people are judging me simply for the fact because I said the games suck. Now, let me look at the launch lineup real quick. I'm not prepared, like I said. Let me look at the list of games. Alright. If I can find it, hopefully. Alright. So, you got games like Nintendo Land. Now, I do want to get the Deluxe Wii U just to have Nintendo Land free with all those other stuff. So, I probably will get Nintendo Land, though I probably will not play Nintendo Land. I don't know if I heard correctly, but I'm pretty sure Nintendo Land doesn't even have online. So, it's kind of stupid. Like, this is your launch game, it's a party game, you know. Every time I think of party, it's playing with friends. Now, doesn't mean I have to have friends in the house, but do I really have to do that? Is this Stone Age? Like, I really have people come over just to play split screen, because what's the share of screen nowadays? Like, if you have a big ass TV, you want that big ass TV to yourself, so. This hat's annoying me, man. I'm not even sure why I'm still wearing it this late. But yeah, like, why would I want a party game that I can't play online? Like, personally, it's just me. And then I'll check out, let's see, best Wii U games. New Super Mario Bros. U. Now, I do want the game, but I'm not gonna buy a system for it. It ain't that big of an impact for me to have a reason to buy. Now, let's see. Never had Zombie U. Like I said, I've listed my complaints about Zombie U. Like, I'm not getting zombie you. That's fine. A lot of gamble shit. Like, I'm sorry. Scribblenauts Unlimited. They got that on Steam. Personally, I wouldn't want to buy it. They had it on Steam, so like half off, and I still didn't buy it. That's not really a big launch game, in my opinion. You can lie all you want to yourself. That's not a big launch game, in my opinion. Assassin's Creed 3, that's a good game. But people who already had a 360, PS3, hell, I think even it's on PC, I might be wrong. But why would we want it if we already have it? Sonic All-Stars, again, we have that. I can't find the rest of the list. I'm pretty sure you also had Ninja Gaiden 3 Razor's Edge, which I don't know if it's the definitive version of it. You have Aliens, Colonial, Marines. I don't care what anybody says. I'm not buying a game based on like a movie thing or something. If I'm not mistaken, Aliens is based on the Aliens movie. If not, I'm horribly mistaken. I apologize, but I'm not going to buy it. I'm pretty sure it's also on other consoles. Batman Arkham City Armored Edition. I've seen the frame rate. It's actually worse than the actual versions. Bayonetta 2. Now, Bayonetta 2. I didn't play Bayonetta 1. Surprisingly, even though I played like every game, I wanted to play Bayonetta 1, but I probably would buy a system just to play Bayonetta 2. I don't know. It depends on the length of it and if it lives up to hype. Now, of course, I'm gonna want to play Bayonetta 1 before it, so I won't buy one when it first comes out. I will see the reviews of it, see if it lives up to the hype, and check that out. Cabela's, nobody likes those. Call of Duty, I don't give a shit. It's a generic shooter, just like Aliens. I'm assuming that's a shooter, I think it is. Darksiders 2, I don't give a shit. You know, I've heard terrible things about it. Like, it's not a terrible game, but it's not as good as it could be. And you got Dirt, no one care about that. Epic Mickey, ooh, I don't care. Dragon Quest 10, not that game could probably sell a system, I'd admit, but it's not my type of game, so be honest. I play RPG games. I got Tales of Graces F and stuff like. What's my other shitty RPG? Like, I bought a game called Valhalla Knights. What a piece of shit that was. I got Tales of Symphonia over here. I don't play that many RPGs anymore because they're too long for me. And I get bored easy nowadays with games. So maybe that's personally, I don't want a Wii U also, like Tales of Symphonia. I'd probably buy it for that though, because that shit would last mad long, I'd admit. F1 Racing, don't give a shit. I don't care about the family games. FIFA 13, don't give a shit. Fist of North, I don't even know what the hell that is. Game Warrior, Injustice, Gods Among Us. This is Warner Bros. I'm pretty sure it's based on a movie or something. Jeopardy, don't care. Just Dance, don't care. Lego City, now people keep mentioning Lego Cities. I don't care what anybody says. Why would I want to play Lego City when Grand Theft Auto 5 is coming out? Like, I mean, I understand, like, if you like the Lego games, but those games are so bad to me, all the Lego games. You can't tell me with a straight face that Lego games are that good to sell me a system. You can't, don't even joke to me. Like, I don't care, man. Like, Marvel the Avengers, I'm pretty sure that will come out for everything else. Mass Effect 3. Mass Effect 3, I already have it. All that money. So that's not selling me on it though. Mass Effect is a big series. They don't even have 1 and 2, so why the fuck would I want it? Yeah, I like transferring my data from my 1 and 2 file. Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate. Like I said, after trial, I'm worn out from Monster Hunter. Like, I played that shit for like 100 hours. I doubt I could do that again and dedicate it, because it's like starting from scratch 1. I'm going to have to get the same bootleg ass Jaggy armor. If it has the same enemies, I'm gonna have to fucking fight the Quadrupeco or Kirapeco or whatever the fuck they wanna call it, then the Wraithian, the Rathalos, and I just don't give a shit about Monster Hunter again. Like, I bought Monster Hunter Freedom Unite, I think, or two, Freedom Night 2, I don't know, for the on the PSN for my Vita, and I just wasn't in the mood to play Monster Hunter anymore. I mean, unless they added new moves and stuff, I just really don't care. Like, I mean, it's a good series, don't get me wrong, but it's not gonna sell me on a system. Like, I'm sorry, looks good, but Nintendo and Pikmin 3. Pikmin 3, alright, now. Let me. Pikmin. Humble. Now, do I like Pikmin? Yes. I like Pikmin. Will I buy a system for Pikmin? No. No way in hell I would buy a game. Like, I got this for $20, right? And I got this for $20. Why am I gonna pay $60 for Pikmin when I don't even like Pikmin that much for the price I paid? Like, it's they're good games, don't get me wrong. It's just depends on the type of game you are. Now, I guess it depends on taste. I didn't play that much of 2 yet, but I like the freedom of 2. So, yeah, I don't like the time system. If they have the times 3, fuck out of here. I ain't buying Pikmin. I ain't buying a Wii U for Pikmin specific. Like, I'll buy it. Just I'll buy it when it's like drops in price or some shit. You know, and maybe I'll get it. But yeah, I can't see it being worth it. Now let me clarify this. Rayman, whatever they call it, Legends is it? Let me make sure so I'm not wrong. Yeah, Rayman Legends. Now people keep asking me, oh, how are you gonna judge the system based on the game that's not even out yet and you only played the demo? Now, that doesn't mean I didn't play anything else. Like I said, people aren't gonna assume that I've played the other stuff, of course, but from what I've played of the Wii U, I've played everything besides. What? Besides what? I've pretty much played everything. It's just most of the third party's already out, or, like, at least the ones I've. Like, I'm not gonna buy it for that. Like, Pikmin, I won't buy it for Rayman. I definitely won't buy it for. I mean, Rayman, it's a good game. Don't get me wrong, but I'm not gonna buy, like, a system to play Rayman. Like, seriously. When I play the demo, it's more of the same of what it's called, the Origins. And Origins, while it was good, did not capture my attention that much. Now, people are questioning me of why, how am I basing my impressions on what I've played? Because what I've played is enough to determine if I like the system or not to purchase it. You don't just go to the store and fucking look at a fucking, wait, what the hell? Look at a fucking camera and just be like, ooh, I need a camera, let me buy one. You know, I'm not actually recording with a camera right now. I'm using my webcam. But I'm not gonna go on a camera and be like, oh, this camera looks nice, let me purchase it right now. You know what you do when you want to buy something? You research it and you try something out. Like, you get a preview of it. Now, a camera, you don't need that much information of because you can just look on YouTube, see how it records, find out the features, and find out everything else it has. Now, that's pretty much what I did with the Wii U, and from what I've played of it, it does not impress me. So, therefore, I'm not gonna shell out $350 and then get another game that will last me maybe like a week, and then I'll be bored of the Wii for months. And people are telling me that launch lineup is impressive when they're mentioning Aliens. I don't want that. Pikmin will not buy a system for that. Lego City, that's a good joke. And fucking Monster Hunter Tri, now, or whatever, Monster Hunter 3 Ultimate. I've already played Monster Hunter. Do I look like I want to play Monster Hunter for like the 1400th time? Well, what else are people suggesting to me? I don't even remember. Let me check the contact, the fucking comments, because I keep forgetting everything. Because this Wii U is not memorable to me. It does not interest me. Like, it interests me enough to the point where I want to get one in the future, but I'm not gonna buy one now. Like, Chrono X Asura says he paid. He had hundreds of hours on it. You know, that's good and all, but depending on what game you play, you'll get 100 hours easy. Right now, I'm playing Pokemon, fucking White 2, and I have like 28 hours, and I only got like 6 badges. That's not impressive to me. Like, I could just buy a game and get 100 hours of, out of that instead of getting a system and then a game just to play like two games and then have nothing for a few months. So, let's see. Let's see what Chrono Exosura and Screw You sent. I guess that dude's like a Super Nintendo. I mean, that's, yeah, Super Nintendo fan. Wow, that sounds like fucking Super Nintendo. Alright. Dragon Quest X. Now, like I said, I would get that. Oh. And the Wonderful 101. Now, that doesn't look good at all. Like, to me at least. Like, I play everything. I'll give it a shot, maybe. Like, if it's like on sale ever, I'll probably buy it. But I ain't getting the Wonderful 101 just to have the Wonderful 101. I ain't gonna lie. I ain't gonna jump on the bandwagon and be like, oh, that's awesome. Just because I'm a Nintendo fan, I gotta get this, you know. That's not me. I buy games I personally want. Like, it was a game I bought that I wanted. Like, you will never hear somebody be like, well, actually, you're probably not answering Klonoa. I wanted Klonoa because I played Klonoa on the PS1. I know that it's good. It interested me. And, like, I've played, I sold a lot of my games, which I kind of regret. Like, I've bought stuff like the Metal Slug Anthology. I've bought stuff like, I actually own a lot of Nintendo games. That's crazy. Yeah, I've showed you a lot of my games, actually. That's too bad. There we go. If I'm not mistaken, it's made. I might be wrong. They made this game, Wonderful 101. Now, I love Mad World. It's actually one of my favorite Wii games. Though it's 6 hours long. Can I trust them with the Wonderful 101? Like, what was there to do after you beat this game? Somebody tell me. This is a long ass video. I'm probably gonna stop at the 20 minute mark. Like, if I'm not mistaken. I actually might be mistaken, so I apologize. Who's making it? Yeah, Platinum Games is making it. If I'm not mistaken, these are Platinum Games. It is Platinum Games. So, yeah. I've loved this game. I've had no doubt that this game was going to be awesome. Now, I love everything Platinum Games does. We could technically call this Platinum Games game, so I have faith in Platinum Games. You know, like I will probably actually like buy Wonderful 101. Just I'm not gonna buy a Wii U just to play Wonderful 101. I love Platinum Games. Now, don't get me wrong, but you know, it's not worth the degree to shell out $350. Now people can be like, oh, you're poor, oh. Yeah, because you just shell out money on shit you don't want. Like, you think I'm going to buy a fucking... You think I'm going to buy a Resident Evil 5 if I didn't want it? Twice? If I was that poor, I wouldn't buy the game twice. Yeah. Actually, it's kind of stupid. I switched the case with it, so it's supposed to actually have a clear case. So it actually looks like I bought it recently. Just finding out. But yeah, like, if I wanted the game, I would like, buy the system for it. Like, I need a game that makes me want the Wii U. And I just don't have that. I don't. Like, what else is on the list? Skylanders, don't care. Sniper Elite, don't care. Sonic All-Stars, again, it's already on the fucking other systems. Tank, I don't even know what the hell that is. Apparently, Roger would be like the best thing in the world. It's like a tag tournament too, like I said, I already have that. Everybody who owned the system already had that. The Walking Dead, everybody's getting that. Transformers Prime, pretty sure everybody will get that. Wii Fit U, Wipeout, and... Yeah, and then somebody also suggested to me, what game is that? Bit Trip Runner. Now, I don't know if you noticed where I put that. Bit Trip Saga. I own it. I like Bit Trip. I love Bit Trip Runner. It's one of my favorite downloadable games. Oh, you can check my Steam. That is Darragon, same way spelled as here. I have it on Steam. Have it on WiiWare. I beat it on WiiWare. I didn't beat it on those because I didn't feel like playing it again. Now I love it. I did play it again. I just think it enough to get far enough to beat it again because that game's a pain in the ass. But that game is launching on Steam. Why would I buy a Wii U when I already have something that can make me play Bit Trip Runner? I already own 3 copies of Bit Trip Runner, the first one. Maybe when I get a Wii U, I will buy Bit Trip Runner again. The thing is, I'm not buying a Wii U just for Bit Trip Runner. I love it. I love the series. I support the devs. That's why I bought it 3 times. So, you know, I don't understand. Like, I don't think you guys understand from the point. From what I've played the Wii U, and from what I've seen of the Wii U and its capabilities, I find it pathetic. Like, by the time the 720 comes out on the PS4, that thing's outdated again. It's gonna be like the Wii. Like, it's gonna suck, which is bad. I love Nintendo. I've bought so many games, like, fucking, I bought Mario and Sonic at the Olympic Games, you know how crappy this is. But I still bought it. Like, I don't think you guys understand. Like, I'm not gonna buy a system for games that I don't want yet. Like, once I get the system, I'll probably buy games I don't want that much. Like, I'll give them a chance, but until then, I'm not gonna shell out that type of money to play a game. I'm not, like, to play a game that doesn't make it worthy to me. Like, I don't know if you understand what I'm saying, but the features of Wii U where you could draw, that's cool, but I could already do that on my 3DS and swap it. Why would I want to do that on the Wii? Am I going to pay $350 to do that? No. The only thing I like about it is the Nintendo Network ID, even though I think you have like a short print code, which is like 6 characters, but it's like random letters or some shit. I find that pretty cool, but I'm not going to shell out shit for like that. And I've also seen that, like, the Wii U didn't even add that much to the Miis. Like, it can't be like Xbox with avatars where they update the shit. Hopefully they do. I mean, pretty sure they could, but that's pathetic. And then also, I never mentioned that the hard drive. I'm not going to get one with a small hard drive where I can't, you know, if I have to patch a game and then one day I have so many games that I can't patch them anymore because I have no space, what am I going to do? Like, that's why I want to get the deluxe one, but there's no justified reason right now. And I know about external hard drives. I actually have one right here. So, I mean, it's a cheap-ass case, so it's not the best external hard drive. That's from an old laptop that I broke apart just to get the hard drive out of it. But yeah, it's like, do I really look like I'm going to shell out money for something I don't want? Well, I do want it, but nothing impresses me to the point where I'm going to buy one, alright? So, I hope you understand my viewpoint from what I've played, and from what I've seen, and from what I've heard from other Nintendo fans and other people. It doesn't mean just because people play Xbox and Wii U, it doesn't mean one's a fanboy for fucking one system. As you can see, I own more Wii games and more 3DS games than I own Vita games. I also own DS games too, and I also own 64 games over here. And fucking my brother has like 60 Xbox games. He's the fanboy of the PS, of the 360. Like, he'll straight up tell me that he doesn't know why I play Nintendo. I tell him I play everything. I play his 360. I play his PS3. In fact, I own more PS3 games than him now. Meanwhile, the system's his. And I played Wii. I own 50 games, I own like 70 downloads on my Wii, I own maybe like, let me check, I have a website that tracks everything. If you want to know about it, it's called backlogree.com. I'm on it, I'm Darragon without a zero, it's actually a O this time, but I own 32 Virtual Console handheld games for my 3DS, I own 19 3DS downloads, and yes, I own a lot. I own some DSiWare games. I own like everything. Like, I don't think that's what you guys understand. I play everything, I enjoy everything, but I'm not gonna buy a system when I have nothing on it that I want. I've done that before. I bought the 3DS, the Super Street Fighter 4, and I was disappointed as hell because I've already played Street Fighter 4. And I've also played, well, I didn't play it, but Samurai Warriors was not keeping me busy. And until the eShop launched, that thing was a shit piece of shit. It's just like the eShop on the Wii U right now. They have, like, nothing on it that I would want. And half the games I could download on it probably will max out the hard drive as is already. So, I think I'm going to end it here. I said I was going to end it at the 20th minute, but now it's hitting the 16th minute. So, I hope you enjoyed my part 2 rant. Hopefully, you listened through the whole thing. Otherwise, I just wasted 25 minutes of my life. 26 minutes, actually, now. But who cares? I'm a gamer. I waste my life gaming. And I don't make vlogs that often until recently. I just started, so I apologize for not planning ahead of time, as always. So I blabber on and on and on and on. So yeah, that's nothing I want. Therefore, Wii U sucks. Right now. Now. I didn't say it will suck in the future. I said, now.